This episode is brought to you by Skillfeed. Whether it's Photoshop, web development, 3D software, photography, or motion graphics, Skillfeed helps you learn it. Get 2 free weeks of membership with no obligation by clicking the link located in the video description, which is located below the title of this video. If you decide to continue membership, it's only $19 a month. Learn what you want, learn what you love. Thanks, Skillfeed, for supporting Blue Lightning TV. Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to easily create this off-registered RGB color effect that you can utilize and apply to a logo or symbol. Go to File and New. Make the width 1550 pixels, the height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. Then click OK. Open your Horizontal Type tool and make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they aren't, press D on your keyboard. Go to Window and Character. The character panel will open. Choose a font. I'm using Aldo the Apache Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in the video description or project files. For this font, I'll choose a size of 174 points, and I'll click the faux italic icon to slant the text. Click on your document and type out your text. If you want to increase the size of a character, highlight it, and drag the size icon to the right. To center the larger character on your line of text, drag the baseline shift icon to the left. To adjust the space between characters, click between those characters, press and hold Alt or Option, and press the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. To reposition your text, open your Move tool and move it. Make 2 copies of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. We'll name the top layer red, the second layer green, and the original layer aqua or cyan. Go to Image, Mode, and make sure RGB color is checked and 8 bits per channel. Click the eyeballs of aqua and green to hide the layers, and click the large T next to red to make the layer active. Click the FX icon and click Blending Options. Next to Channels, you'll see checked boxes for red, green, and blue. Uncheck the red channel to make your text red, then click OK. Hide the red layer and make the green layer visible and active. Click the FX icon and again click Blending Options. Uncheck the green channel to make your text green, then click OK. Hide the green layer and make the aqua or cyan layer visible and active. Click the FX icon, click Blending Options, and uncheck the green and blue channels. Make the other layers visible and the green layer active. Press and hold the Shift key and press the left arrow on your keyboard twice. This moves the green layer to the left 20 pixels. Make the aqua or cyan layer active, press and hold Shift, and press the left arrow key 4 times to move the layer 40 pixels to the left. If you want to make the black characters touch, press the left arrow key without pressing Shift. This moves the aqua layer to the left 1 pixel at a time. Next, we'll separate and off-register the logo. First, let's place the text layers into a folder. To do this, Shift-click on the top layer to highlight all the text layers, then press Ctrl or Command G. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a rectangle over the top half of your logo. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer, which is the text folder. Make a copy of the layer and invert the active layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Make the original folder active and press and hold Shift as you press the right arrow key once. This moves the top half of the logo 10 pixels to the right. Next, we'll add the full name of the company. Go to the bottom of your document and press T to open your type tool. Click on your document and choose a font. I'm using Dosis Book. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll temporarily choose a size of 40 points and type out the company's name. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. For this example, I'd like to resize the line of text so its right edge is flush with the right edge of the logo. To do this, I'll open my Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to the lower right corner, and when I see a diagonal double arrow, I'll press and hold Shift as I drag the corner up and in until the right edge of the text is flush with the right edge of the black character of the logo. Then I'll press Enter or Return and close the character panel. Have fun experimenting with the channel colors and registrations. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.